When you hear the words, hazardous waste, you probably think of a giant vat or a metal barrel with a big danger sign plastered across it. Most hazardous waste come from factories. However, even offices, hospitals, schools, and retail stores generate hazardous waste. And it is important that these wastes are properly managed to keep us safe. That's why there's strict laws in place for managing the disposal of hazardous wastes. These rules include requirements for labeling, transporting, treating, storing, and disposing of these wastes. Most hazardous waste generated from businesses can only be stored, treated, or disposed at highly engineered, licensed hazardous waste facilities, whose license specifies design and operating requirements that must be met to ensure the materials are handled in a way that protects people and our environment. And while hazardous waste that come from our homes is not subject to these stringent rules, it is still best to keep these wastes out of our landfills. Local governments often offer household hazardous waste collections, where residents can bring old paint, lawn chemicals, mercury thermostats, and more. Some retailers even accept items like batteries, fluorescent light bulbs, medications, and electronics to prevent them from going to our landfills. We all need to work together to ensure hazardous waste, whenever generated, is managed in the best possible way. So what makes something a hazardous waste? If it's toxic, ignitable, corrosive, or reactive, then it's probably considered a hazardous waste. If something is toxic, it could make people sick, if it's absorbed through the skin or swallowed. For an example, dry cleaners and factories use solvents for cleaning that contain toxic chemicals. Other common hazardous wastes that are toxic include fluorescent light bulbs that contain mercury and electronics like cell phones and computers that contain toxic metals like lead and cadmium. Another characteristic is ignitable wastes, or materials that can easily catch on fire and burn. Gasolines and paint thinners are easy examples of this. Next, corrosive wastes can cause severe chemical burns or easily eat through metal. Certain strong cleansers and acids can do this. Lastly, reactive waste can be unstable under normal conditions. When compressed, heated, or mixed with water, they can cause an explosion, toxic fumes, gases, or vapors. Examples of this are gunpowder and fireworks. You might have noticed that the definition of hazardous waste does not include every kind of waste that might be harmful. Radioactive materials, medical waste, and solid waste are dealt with under different laws than hazardous waste. Sometimes a waste can fall into more than one category and must be managed for all its hazardous properties. In addition to these four categories, the law also includes a list of waste that come from certain kinds of businesses and are considered hazardous. These lists include solvents, waste from petroleum refining, wood preserving, pharmaceutical manufacturing, and more. To learn more about hazardous waste regulations, check out our resources or contact our Environmental Assistance Center for help. Thanks for watching.